So, you know, you buy a MIDI keyboard to control virtual instruments, but you find that as you add third-party instruments, your MIDI knobs don't always work. And using MIDI map in Ableton won't save your mappings from one song to another. This video will help solve that problem for you. I'll show you how to map any 8 controls in any virtual instrument to your hardware MIDI keyboard controller. And once you do it, you can load up that virtual instrument in any song in the future and Ableton will remember your mappings. Now, if you're new to Ableton Live, check out my beginner's video right here. It'll get you up and running with music creation in Ableton quickly. First of all, make sure that you've selected your MIDI keyboard in the preferences menu in Ableton Live. I'm using the Akai MPK Mini, so I'm gonna choose MPK Mini. And also, you may need to select it in the input and output. This kind of differs for different keyboards. If you don't find your keyboard in this control surface list, check on your keyboard manufacturer's website. They may have some special instructions for Ableton. If not, go ahead and skip ahead to this time in the video, and we'll create one specifically for your keyboard. First, we need to check if your keyboard is already fully compatible with Ableton Live device control. To do this, load up an Ableton Live instrument like the grand piano. Something with knobs. Now move around the knobs on your MIDI keyboard and see if they move the knobs on the grand piano. If they move in sync like they do on the MPK Mini, then your keyboard is already set up to control Ableton devices. You can skip the next portion of this video and forward to this time. If not, keep watching. I'm going to use the Alesis V25 for this example because the V25 doesn't control Ableton Live out of the box. So we need to create a user remote script. This is a one-time setup. First, load up the grand piano on a MIDI track. Click the button at the top right in Ableton Live to open MIDI mapping. We're going to figure out which MIDI CCs that the V25 knobs is sending. So make a note of the numbers Ableton is registering and write them down or something. Click the first knob in Ableton and move your first knob on your keyboard. And then for the next knob in Ableton, move the second knob on your controller. If you have 8 knobs on your keyboard, keep doing this until you know all the MIDI CC numbers that your keyboard is sending to Ableton. Then you can get out of the MIDI mapping. Next, go to this location on your Mac or PC. You'll want to choose the latest version of Live that you have installed. Once you're there, create a new folder. We're going to call it Alesis V25 Macro. Now, copy the file called userconfiguration.txt into the folder you just created. Don't move it, just copy it. And open the userconfiguration.txt file. And we're going to make some changes in here. First, we're going to change the input and output names to the name of our keyboard. This is specifically what you'll find in the preferences in Ableton Live. Look at the input and outputs. For the Alesis V25, it's V25 out and V25 in. These names are really important because that's what I'm going to input here. So for the input name in the user configuration file, I'm going to put in V25 out. This needs to be precisely what is being registered in the preferences menu. Next, go down to device control. So this section, we're going to change the values for the 8 encoders. Now, since Alesis only has 4, I'm only going to change the first 4 values. So I'm going to change them to what I'd written down. Now save that file and close it. Close Ableton Live and reopen it. can go back to preferences. Now I'm going to select something else under control surface, and it's actually the script we just created. Here it is, Elisa's V25 macro. And we ensure that we've got the input and output selected. And now let's test out that grand piano. Check it out, the knobs work. Now let's move on to setting up control with any other third-party virtual instrument like Serum, Omnisphere, Diva, and so many others. Next, load up a virtual instrument that you want to map to your keyboard. This can be any virtual instrument out there. I'm gonna load Serum, which is a popular third-party synth plugin, but really, you can load any other virtual instrument. Now, you'll notice right away that the knobs on my MIDI controller don't control anything in Serum. We're gonna fix that. Click the triangle button on the device, that's here at the bottom left, and then click the configure button. Now move any parameter in Serum that you wanna control with your MIDI controller keyboard. You can choose up to 8 controls. Once you've done that, click the configure button again to get out of that. Now, right-click on the Serum device and press group. Then, click the knob button, which is right here. Now you have 8 knobs that you can map to those parameters that we just created the configure for. Press the map button and start connecting your configuration controls to the 8 knobs. Then click the map button again to get out of the mapping. Once you've done that, click the save button here on the instrument rack area and name your new instrument. I'm gonna call this Serum Mini Lab Control. Now, anytime you want to control Serum with your MIDI keyboard, just load up that instrument you just saved. All right, first let's test out those knobs we just mapped. Next, I'm going to open a new project in Ableton and load this instrument, and you'll see that all the mappings remain. That was pretty quick. If you found this video useful, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Make the music you love, and hey, check out one of these videos next.